But in this case, he has improved a lot. He has got some shockwave, how many times? Three, five?
Five times.
Five times shockwave, and he has improved a lot, actually. You don't have any pain now, really.
Small, very
small. Only small pain, yeah. He's playing tennis on a semi-professional basis, isn't it?
Rendszeres tenisz, ez a probléma egyébként az volt, hogy a vállat nem tudta használni. Az öt kezelés után az AC ízület is nagyon érzékeny volt, azt én nagyon kicsit kezeltem, de az első, második kezelés után az sokat javult, és az ő masszőre, akivel dolgozik, az jelentős funkciójavulást, hogy rendszeresebben
látom.
Gyakorlatilag eljutottuk valameddig, és akkor láttam fel, tehát most a bizonyos skálát nem tudnám belőni, szerintem a 10-ből a 2 felé tartunk, vagy 3 maximum, de újabb problémákat találtunk, most aki másodiknak jön, és most okosabb, mint én, hál' Istennek, talán még tudok javítani a Kálmánon.
Now if he's telling jokes about me, then you have to tell it after to me. Okay?
Ja, tehát azt mondja, hogyha egy viccet mesélek róla, utána
okay. Listen up here. Let me just show you here. I just want to draw the anatomy for you, so you know what structures we're dealing with, okay? And I think that if you have to treat a shoulder, draw it the first couple of times. I usually do it still. I usually draw on my patients, you know. Now, I want to find the acromion first. So when you have to find the acromion, you draw at the line of the spine of scapula. The spine of scapula is composed by the acromion in the end part, in the distal part. So I find the spine of scapula. And I draw that, and I draw the AC joint. If you cannot find the AC joint, sometimes it can be difficult to find the joint line, then you move the hand. When you move the hand, you can feel the joint line. You can feel the joint line moving up or down. If you cannot feel it this way, you do translation. Then you will find it.
Okay?
And if you look at this patient, try and turn around just to watch them, like this. If you look at this patient, do you see a difference at the AC joint? Do you see that this one is bigger? Mm-hmm. What does that indicate? That indicates that he is a right-handed tennis player. He's using that hand more. That is why he has a little bit arthrosis in this joint, maybe. Or at least some calcific deposits, maybe, in the joint line. Or the joint line is not smooth. It is a little bit atypical. Okay?
Egy kis degenerációt azt mondja, hogy tulajdonképpen observációval is, ha ahogy tetszik, látunk annak ellenére, hogy esetleg egyébként nem tartom az útra, lehet, hogy kitérje az AC-ízület felépítésére, de ő megsatszolja így látványra, hogy ez egy kicsit degenerált ez az AC-ízület.
Now, if you look at that one, you can see that there is a problem. Yeah, you can almost see that. And also, Emil was very smart. He actually treated this joint as well with the shockwave a little bit because he was a little bit afraid of doing something wrong. It's a good, it's a safe situation. Now, ladies and gentlemen, explain me, where are the positions of the infraspinatus, the supraspinatus, the teres minor, and the subscapularis? Does anybody want to come up and draw them? No.
Gergő.
You have to translate. He can do it because we've done it a lot of times, you know. So that's not a problem. But let me just show you. What we saw on the drawing up here was that the supraspinatus is actually right in the joint line, wasn't it?
The supraspinatus has a vonalban.
Yeah. But how do you remember the placement of those muscles? You write TIS. Teres minor, infraspinatus, supraspinatus, subscapularis. TIS from behind. TIS is P in Norwegian, so it's very easy to remember. So most people can remember that. So now we know that in about this line we will have the supraspinatus. So it's not here. Okay? So don't forget that, please. Be good in your anatomy. Now, do another thing here. Palpate the bicipital groove. The bicipital groove is easy to palpate because you can feel it sliding under your fingers. Yeah? Now, if I have to draw the bicipital groove, I will do it. So the biceps is not right over the biceps. The biceps is much more medially. Please know your anatomy. Because if you have to treat a biceps tendinosus, don't treat it here. Because that's not a biceps tendinosus, is it? A biceps tendinosus is here. So do it right. Now, how do you find processus coracoideus? Because that's another important part. You stand behind the patient, you slip your finger over the clavicle, and about 1 centimeter to 1.5 centimeters below the lateral 1/3 of the clavicle is the coracoid process. And you will palpate it easily in the area, and the patient will feel some soreness in that area. Which muscle is attached to the pec minor? Oh,
no, I answered my question.
Oh, stupid answer. Okay. Okay. So now we have all the structures, yes? Now, the problem with this patient is that his shoulder pain has almost gone completely. But I will show you how Emil started the treatment of the shoulder, okay? And then I will also treat one of the trigger points on him, because we found one area which is really sore on him, and I want you to be clever and together with me figure out what muscle we're talking about.
Tehát találtunk egy fájdalompontot azon túlmenően, hogy ugye bárkezelésről beszélünk, és ezt kérdezi tőletek, hogy van is rájött, hogy mi az a fájdalmas pont.
The machinery is very, very easy to operate. Cool. But not without power.